Good morning, everybody. Just a really quick video from me regarding the number of resignations we're seeing at the moment in regards to Brexit. It's just a really quick video from me because I'll take this stuff on tomorrow and the day after because I've got some time off work. We've seen so many resignations now. We've seen so much posturing over the last couple of years. We've heard so many promises. And what I'm hoping now is, as an electorate, we can learn the lessons from the Brexit process and what kind of happened before Brexit in order to make sure things like this don't happen again. I make this channel for people who maybe have a kind of passing interest in politics, and that on the surface of things, people like Theresa May, Boris Johnson, Jacob Rees-Mogg, Liam Fox, all of these characters within the cabinet, they may seem like trustworthy characters, David Cameron. They may seem like trustworthy characters who represent you. But I think if anything, the last couple of years of politics have told you that these people aren't really out here for you. These people aren't really representing you. We all go to work trusting the government to do the best by us and do a very good job. And I think what Brexit has shown us is that these people aren't doing that. What they're trying to do is preserve their own self-interest and preserve their own careers. And how many times as a country or as Tory party voters do you want to keep on trusting people like Theresa May and David Cameron and all of the jokers in that cabinet without any results? When is the country going to start looking better? When are we going to see more representation for people? If you can't see that coming, then maybe we should stop voting for these people. Brexit might be a really harsh lesson for the British public in regards to who you can and can't trust, and why if they say strong and stable over and over again, we need to ask why they're saying that rather than just taking it as, you know, read that they are strong and stable. Because now we see more dramatic exits than a Game of Thrones episodes, and we're talking about the government cabinet here. It's been quite a you-know-what show from the government at the moment, and now we see Labour Party politicians, I can see, that are trying to say we should get behind the government, but I thought these guys were hard right kind of Brexiteers that we should be opposing at every step. I'm just a bit confused as what to think and who to trust at the moment. And if I've got my own political platform and I'm saying this, what is the average person in the UK thinking? So you guys let me know your thoughts. What are the main lessons we can take from Brexit? What have you learned that maybe you didn't know before? Be looking forward to catching up with a few people over the next few days. Captain Switzerland and Pauline will be on the platform as well. I'll be talking to you guys about Brexit. So yeah, have a good day. Let me know your thoughts below. I'll see you soon.